Hello everyone, Professor Franz here. In this clip, I'm going to talk about limitations to monetary policy. There are two major limitations. First, timing issue, and second, liquidity trap. Here are some limitations to monetary policy. The first is a timing issue. We first have a recognition lag. Recognition lag is this. Sometimes a recession already happened, but we're not aware of it until the following months, when the number prepared by the Bureau of Labor Statistics become available. So that's a recognition lag. We don't know that we're in recession, or we don't know that we have an inflation until a later time. The second is implementation lag. That's a period between enactment of a policy and the start of its effects. So for example, after a policy is implemented, it takes some time for the policy to kick in. Kind of like when you take Tylenol, you don't feel the Tylenol reduce your headache until, say, half an hour later. That's the implementation lag of a monetary policy. And notice that in a monetary policy, there is no legislative lag, which is great because the Federal Reserve is independent of our government. Liquidity trap is a situation when increasing money supply no longer lowers the interest rate. In that case, an expansionary monetary policy will no longer help the economy out of the recession. Here is a graphical analysis of a liquidity trap. Suppose currently our money supply is M3 and we're in a recession. Now suppose the Federal Reserve conducts an expansionary monetary policy to increase our money supply from M3 to M4. Notice that this increase in money supply does not lower our interest. And because interest rate doesn't go down, investment does not go up. And that will not shift our aggregate demand curve to the right. So our expansionary monetary policy becomes ineffective.